In part one of our lesson on complex numbers, you will learn how to simplify radicals and solve equations with complex numbers. So remember that complex numbers are written in the form a plus bi, where a is the real part and b, which is the coefficient of the I, is the imaginary part. In the complex number system, I stands for the square root of negative 1, so then that would mean that I squared is equal to negative 1. And this is the big difference between the real number system, which is what we've been using all semester up until this point, and the complex number system. In real numbers, the square of something could never be negative, but in complex numbers, I squared is negative 1. So let's see how this works. In this first example, we will simplify each radical. So the square root of negative 4, we can think of it as radical 4 times radical negative 1. We know that radical 4 reduces to 2, and the square root of 1 gets replaced with I. Next, we have the square root of negative 7. So we have radical negative 1 times radical 7. And the reason I put the radical 7 last was because it is irreducible, meaning that there are no perfect squares that are factors of 7. So this becomes I radical 7. And it's standard to leave your answers in terms of having the irreducible part come last. It wouldn't be incorrect if you had written this radical 7 times I, but the danger in writing it that way is that sometimes students will write it radical 7i, where the I is under the radical, and that can never happen. To be on the safe side, it's best to put the I in front of the radical 7. In this next one, we have the square root of negative 50. 50 has as a factor the perfect square of 25, so we would write radical 25, we have radical negative 1, and radical 2. And again, the reason I'm writing the radical 2 last is because it is an irreducible radical. When we simplify this, it becomes 5i radical 2. In this next example, we have to simplify each expression. We start off with radical negative 5 times radical negative 5. Now that first radical negative 5, we know we can write as I rad 5 times the second radical negative 5 is also I radical 5, because the I is the square root of negative 1 in each case. So we have I times I is I squared, radical 5 times radical 5. We know that I squared is negative 1, and radical 5 times radical 5 is 5. Here, we have radical negative 18 over radical 12. So in the numerator, We have a perfect square of 9 is a factor. So we'll write this as radical 9. We've got a negative, so you can write it as radical negative 1 if you want, or you can go ahead and just write it as I. And then we have radical 2 left. In the denominator, 12 has a perfect square of 4, so we will write that as radical 4, radical 3. The numerator becomes 3i, radical 2, and the denominator becomes 2, radical 3. Now we have to rationalize this fraction, and we know that we're going to multiply by 1 in the form of radical 3 over itself. In the numerator, we get 3i. Now when we multiply radical 2 times radical 3, it becomes radical 6. We know we have a rule from our algebra class that says if we have radical A times radical B, it becomes radical AB. And that's what we did here. Radical 2 times radical 3 became radical 6. In the denominator, we have 2, and then here we have this radical 3 times radical 3, which we know is going to become 3. So we have 2 times 3, which is equal to 6. Now the 3 and the 6 will cancel. So the 3 divided by 3 is 1, 6 divided by 3 is 2. So this reduces to I radical 6 over 2. Now notice we can't do any more reducing here. Because the 6 is under the radical, it cannot reduce with the 2, which is not under a radical. So this would be the simplest form of the answer. In this next expression, we have radical negative 10 over radical negative 5. So we know that the numerator is I radical 10. The denominator is I radical 5. So the I in the numerator will cancel with the I in the denominator, so those are going to disappear. And both of these are under the radical. From our algebra class, we remember that if we have radical A divided by radical B, that becomes radical of A over B. So radical 10 over radical 5 would be radical 10 over 5, which is radical 2. In this next example, we have to solve the equation x squared plus 24 is equal to 0. So the first step would be to subtract 24 from both sides. So now we have x squared is equal to negative 24. Applying the square roots property, we would get that x is equal to plus or minus the square root of negative 24. Now we will need to simplify that radical. So we get that x is plus or minus, well, the perfect square that we can pull out of 24 is 4. So this would be radical 4. We've got that square root of negative 1, so we can go ahead and write that as I. And then the irreducible part of the radical would be 6. So this will simplify to x is plus or minus 2i radical 6. In this example, we have to solve the equation 3x squared is equal to 2x minus 3. We've had a lot of experience solving quadratics. We know that the first step is to get everybody on one side, so we will rewrite this equation as 3x squared minus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now, if we can factor, that would be great. We know that 3 is going to be 1 times 3, and over here, this 3 would be 1 times 3. And we start looking for product pairs that would add up to be negative 2. So if we had a negative 3 from this and a negative 3 from this, we see we would get negative 6, not negative 2. So that's not it. If we tried a 3 times 3 to get a negative 9, and a 1 times 1 and made it a negative 1, we can see that would add up to be negative 10, not negative 2. So this quadratic is not factorable, so none of those are going to work, which means it's prime. When a quadratic is prime, that means we are going to have to use the quadratic formula. So let's remind ourselves, when we have an equation in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then we can solve that using the quadratic formula, and it becomes x is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. So let's apply this quadratic formula here to our equation. This is going to become x is equal to negative b would be negative of negative 2 plus or minus the square root. We have to do b squared, so that's negative 2 squared minus 4 times a, which is 3, times c, which is also 3. Put that whole thing over 2 times a, and remember a is equal to 3. So this will become x is equal to 2 plus or minus. Well, let's come over on the side and work on this radical so we don't have to keep writing this whole equation a million times. We have the square root of negative 2 squared is going to be 4 minus 3 times 3 is 9, 4 times 9 is 36. So this is the square root of negative 32. 32 has a perfect square of 16 in it, so we will write this as radical 16. The negative 1 we know is I, and we have the irreducible part, radical 2, left. So this is 4i radical 2. And now we'll take this and bring it back in to our solution equation here. 4i radical 2 divided by 2 times 3, which is 6. Now in the numerator, We have a common factor of 2 that we can factor out. So the numerator becomes 2 times 1 plus or minus 2i radical 2. In the denominator, we have that 6. And now, of course, we can do canceling here. 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 6 3 times. So finally, we get x is equal to 1 plus or minus 2i radical 2 divided by 3. And that is our solution in simplest form.